Please start.
Yeah. A pleasant day to everyone, those who are here on this platform of Zoom for the Global Train the Trainers Certification Batch number 2. I am Dr. Ravi Kumar from Bangalore, India, a master trainer, a facilitator, an international communication coach, international mentor, and an international counselor, and also a spiritual trainer and a spiritual preacher at ISKCON. I am also a Reiki healer and also a natural therapist. It is my first and foremost honor, privilege, and prestige to welcome all our guests on board over here. Before I do that, it is my privilege and honor to thank our founder, Advocate Piyush Pandit sir, from the depth of my heart, and also extend my gratitude unto him, for who is the backbone of this International Internship University and who has put in all his efforts to spread the wings of International Internship University across the globe in all the 7 continents and 195 countries. Dr. Piyush Pandit is an educational visionary who has completely served the education sector and is still serving the educational sector, and is totally dedicated himself in developing the educational sectors across the globe. And he is one of the main cause for bringing up the World Education Policy Summit also across the globe. And I'm also pleased, privileged, and honored to thank and extend my gratitude to the chairperson of the India chapter, Dr. Snigdha Kadam, who is the backbone of the India chapter and who has put in her day and day out to make this International Internship University a strong one in India. Last but not the least, it is my privilege and honor to welcome our Vice Chancellor of the International Internship University, Dr. Charles Ifobia Professor, Dr. Chap General. He is always there with us. I have never seen him miss even a single session of any batches and training we conduct here, whether it is a resource batch or any training batches, whatsoever it is. Introduce to all the participants about the today's speakers, one who is none other than our famous resource person of the International Internship University, one of the great accolades, Dr. Srividya Sukumar. Dr. Srividya Sukumar is a research and development strategic transformation consultant. She is an educationist, entrepreneur, quality assurance expert, master coach of development business. She is also a volunteer at UNESCO, UNICEF, of Emirates Red Crescent, IA Mato Foundation, Sharjah Social Welfare. She is also there in the Global Panel Board member with GSFN, that is the Global Sustainable Features Vision Global. Dr. Srividya Sukumar is also a member with many organizations. To name the few, she is one of the World Human Rights Protection Commission certified life member. As I told you earlier, she is a research global chairperson with GFSN, and she is the director of N2 Gate Global Dubai UAE. She is also a program director in the International Research and Development Creativity
I think we missed to serve that.
Yes, he has logged out. No worries, I'll continue with the introduction. It's my pleasure. Sir, have introduced Dr. Srividya ma'am. I just wanted to tell you that she is our strong support of the IIU. She is always there for us. Very rightly, sir said, Dr. Srividya Srikumar, she is an educationist, entrepreneur, quality assurance expert. She is the master coach of life and business. She is a volunteer at UNESCO, UNICEF, Emirates Red Crescent, AI Mukutam Foundation, Sharaz School Welfare. She is the global panel board member of GSFN, that is Global Sustainable Futures, IGN Global. She is the director of Edu UGATE Global Dubai UAE. She is the program director for International Research and Development Creativity Organization, Research Innovation Startup University. She is the country director at our International Internship University. She is our IIU UAE country director. So if I'll go on reading her, her expertise, her work, her profile is a very strong and a very big profile. So certainly it's our privilege to have such a great trainer, educationist, researcher today with us. So thank you, Ravi sir, for her introduction. I can understand the technical glitches. So with a warm welcome, Dr. Srividya, the floor is all yours. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Srividya. Thank you so much. I don't know, my other video is not on here on the mobile. Kindly excuse me for the same. I'm deeply humbled by the introduction that is given. And it's a great privilege and honor to be a part of this trainer program as such. And of course, I was there for Dr. Ravi Kumar's session yesterday. It was a very, very interesting session and down-to-earth session, which we were all able to relate ourselves in a very simple way as such. And moving forward, my humble good evening and respects to Dr. Charles, and who has been our pillar of support for each and every program that has been conducted by IIU. Thank you, sir. Thanks for being here. And with all due respects to each and every one of you who have joined us in today's session, I think we should go ahead with the session because otherwise we'll be losing our time. So thank you, Dr. Srividya ma'am. Thanks for this opportunity. And she has been always, as Dr. Ravi Kumar was mentioning, she has been always a pillar of support for each and every IIU activity that has been conducted. Thank you, ma'am. Thanks for this opportunity. So can I go ahead sharing my screen?
Yes, please. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you. So as we all know, today's session is on basically about problem solving. In the beginning of this, today, right now, within the short span of 10 minutes or 15 minutes, we have resolved two problems. One is my audio control, which didn't work on my laptop because, that is another story behind. I didn't have my laptop, though Srividya madam was asking today, do you want me to share your presentation? I said, no, I can manage because I manage another laptop. And so I thought that I will be able to present it, basically. So that was one problem, which was resolved. And when I took this laptop, I was very keen about the video because I need to share my screen. I didn't check the audio control. I was thinking that audio is working, but still, when we connected, it didn't work actually the way I was thinking. Well, moving ahead, this was resolved. Then the third is that how to resolve it? Somehow we just locked it and made it happen. So the main quintessence of today's session is that with the art of problem solving, how can we make things happen? That's the thing. So in every walk of life, adversity is inevitable. We all know it. And overcoming the adversity requires nurturing and strengthening one's own psychology, body armor, that provides the capacity to regenerate, recoup, relearn, to rebound and recoil and return to the original shape. That's what happened today right in front of you. So that's what is the problem of art of problem solving is all about. And do you need to bounce back or fall apart when something goes wrong, think, what should we do in that situation? So what is required out of us? How can we manage the situation? So that's what we need to look into. And the ability to adapt of life's misfortunes and the setbacks and harness the inner strength to rebound from the setback and challenge is called as becoming resilient. To recover, recoil in the physical sciences, the meaning is elasticity and the power of returning to the original shape after compression. So this is the science behind it. So let's think more about it in today's session. When something in life goes unexpected, not the way we were expecting. So the important thing is knowing how to turn these problems into opportunities. That's what is the thing. So from problem to no problem. From problem to no problem. So people's effectiveness in life is determined by their outlook. Many people perceive the perspectives in life are the problem focused rather than solution focused. So that's what is the thing. How am I going to resolve this issue rather than focusing on the problem? So that means they concentrate on what they don't have rather than what they have and what they can do. When our outlook on life becomes solution based, then we have the time to focus on what we have and focus our energy directed towards on getting what we need or what we want to be. So this session is definitely not about the problem, but about the positive thinking, this that is positive working that the mantras, Buddha mantras that can make people feel better and make things happen and produce results. So however, the default is not very permanent unless you allow it to do so, and the results become upon your attitude and your focus on exactly what you are focusing on. So on that note of positive attitude, let's go into the session of how to quickly you can turn your defeat into your victory. That's what is the art of problem solving is all about. Sometimes greatest problems we have in life are in the situation or the circumstances, but sometimes they are with the people themselves or in our life. So in that case, how do we go about what is required out of us to make things happen? That's what we're going to do. So on the overview, not going into detail, when we have a problem, you identify the problem, brainstorm it for solution. What could be done? What could be the next P, plan B, plan C? Consider the possible consequences. What could be the outcome of it? So try out the best solution possible and check whether it's working. So if it's working, then it's fine. Otherwise, this again is a learning experience for one more encounter. So that's how the problem solving is all about on the overview. Hope you will agree with me. So if a person comes to you, say for example, we are all on the platform of trainers, a trainer or a coach, future coach, say. So when a person is going to come and explain their problem to us with the problem, how are we going to deal with the situation? How are you going to look at them? What are the main things that we need to know from that person? Is that? So you can make them comfortable, have a chat with them, let them introduce themselves, and slowly get into the problem, analyzing the problem process. So why is this problem a problem? You have to understand the person, the individual who has come to you first in the first place, to know why is this problem, what they are highlighting or what they are citing is a problem. And what effect does this problem have on your life? The person's life. And what is the specific problem? What is the actual problem on a screen? When this is a problem, when is the problem at its worst? When is the problem is not a problem at all? And who or what is involved in this problem? Say for example, if you allow me for two minutes, I will just explain the situation. Let's go ahead with the situation so that you will be able to understand it much better. That was, I hope that you're seeing me on the screen. I'm not sure that whether you're able to see me, but still. It is a corporate scenario where a corporate female who joined a new firm has come to a counselor saying that the counselor who is there in the culture department saying that I'm not quite happy with that. Everybody is looking at me in a different angle, and everyone has a problem, and nobody is extending support. Nobody is willing to accept me as a person who has walked into your company new. And so many problems that she cited. The counselor listened to her very patiently, and she said, okay, for 1 week, what you do? You come and wish them good morning. Instead of you waiting for them to come and wish you good morning, you go ahead to them, say good morning to everybody. Hope you're fine, and you can bring some sweets or anything that you want to share. So when this happened, she opened up, she bloomed, and so that she was a close person, opened up to the exact situation, the environment, and people started walking to her, and she started welcoming them. So this is how the problem is. So you should understand the person who has come to you with a problem rather than looking at the problem themselves. It may also help to categorize a problem. Common categories of issues clients will come up to you and link to the families and relationships, loss, isolation, loneliness, work-related issues, study-related stress, divorce, separation, unemployment, harassment, bullying, living circumstances, finances, legal issues, or maybe alcohol and drug issues, physical and mental illness, low self-esteem, etc. And this, believe me, this list goes endless as such. So we are trying to highlight few of them. So if they have multiple problems, you need to encourage to choose them one by one and wish to resolve them on one by one basis, such that you are a good person, to have a very positive rapport. First is that, to build a positive rapport, becoming positive to the situation is very, very important. That's the first step of the problem solving process. The second is analyzing the problem, involving working with our clients to identify how the problem is manifested in their life and what's of the life is unfolding and who is the problem actually impacting, if at all it is impacting anyone. The questions which can be useful in this particular situation is, what proof do you have that this problem is real? How often does this problem occur? How does this problem show itself? What is driving this problem? What does the problem bother you? How does the problem? Why does the problem bother you? And what is the severity of the problem? And what could be the other perspective which you can analyze this problem? So you can ask questions to understand the situation much better, such that they open up and they become more clear of exactly what is the problem. So people with problem, when they come to us, they look for solutions. So in the mind of exactly what is comfortable to them, that is what is very, very important. What is comfortable to them, what is adaptable to them, what is in the sense they are happy with the solution, in the sense like as a coach or as a trainer, they expect you to give them the solution, such that not to one problem, with one single solution they will be able to solve multiple problems, or otherwise one solution will be able to solve the multiple problems of this. So this is how people come to us. So as a coach or a trainer, we should be aware of exactly the person who has come to us. The first point is that you know your person very clearly, so that you will be able to analyze the problem and you will be able to give the rightful solution. So choosing a solution at this stage, now when we work with a person, to list the potential solutions they can come up, and please make sure in that case, let them come with their own situation. So you can ask them questions, you can give them instances saying that if this is the situation, how would you react to it? If this is the situation, how would you react to it? This is the situation. Give them multiple, you create the environment for them, you create the circumstances for them, let them arrive at their own conclusions and their own solutions, so that they are very happy with that, saying that, okay, I took the decision and I am the person who is choosing the solution. That is another key thing in the problem solution method. So the solution becomes the best for your client, and you can test it successfully by asking the question, will this idea of the solution be good for you or will it benefit you? Ask them to put it down in writing. Will this idea or solution be good for other people? Will it benefit other people? So ask them to give solutions, suggestions like that. It will help my mom, it will help my friend, it will help my boss, it will help my colleague. like that. Let them put it down. How much time and effort will this idea of association require to arrive at that? What will be the cost and benefits of it? So ask them to draft an answer for all these questions that you need to ask them time and again, such that they are very comfortable with this. Finally, arriving at a solution, what is very important is what are the advantages of the solution, what are the disadvantages of the solution, basically like a SWOT analysis method, that is strengths, weakness, opportunities and threats. So let them do a SWOT analysis of the solution that they have arrived at by your guidance. Remember that as a trainer, as a coach, we are only guiding them or leading them to a solution. We are not taking any solution for them. So in that case, this SWOT analysis is also very important. So they are aware of the shortcomings, they are aware of the weaknesses, they are aware of the advantages also. Also, what is the opportunities and what are threats they will be able to analyze it very clearly. So in that case, they will have the plan B very clearly be ready with it. So arriving at a solution, ask your person, are you happy with the solution? So you have arrived at the solution. You have made the solution. I was only a guide for you. So ask them to list it down. So during our counseling, what is very important is the point to point where you write it down very clearly. Write down the problem. Analyze the problem. Analyze all the points of the problem from different matters as well. So when you arrive at the problem, then how do you analyze this? How to go about to the solution? When you arrive at the solution, do a SWOT analysis such that it is able to resolve the solution. So this is what is important. So writing your plan is very, very important. How to execute it. When you have a plan very clearly, what is very important, the process of implementing stages again going to be very crucial. What will happen in the implementation state? As we all know, as we are going to implement things, we should be aware, we should be conscious of all the problems which can come up, because we have done the SWOT analysis. We know exactly what are the threats that we are going to face. So this is already written down and they are very clear about that. So you can explore them by asking them different types of questions that you can ask in this particular situation. So what could be the question that you can ask is, what could be the, I need to share one more document. So I need to stop sharing this. Let me go to the question part of it. So there are different types of questions that we need to ask them. So I will go to them one by one. Okay. So when they have arrived at the solution, what you can ask them for is for the evidence of thought and against it. What would be against it? Am I basing this thought on facts or feelings? That's what we need to ask them to go probe into it. Is it on factual data or is it according to my feelings? Why is this very important? It is the difference between the intelligence quotient and the emotional quotient. That's what is the thing. We are trying to arrive at a balance between the intelligence quotient and the emotional quotient. Is this thought black and white, and when is the reality become complicated? This is very important, such that we can have in black and white. When they have a problem, how they are going to address this problem? Could I be misinterpreting the evidence? Am I making assumptions? So when they make an evidence, when they making an assumption or a solution to this problem, are they going to give us evidential solution? Is this going to give us an evidential solution? How are we going to look into it? So all these type of questions we need to ask them exactly, so that they are very clear with exactly what is expected out of them, and such that they will be able to move further. So moving ahead, I need to go down now. 1 minute, one more data I need to check. My laptop, okay, let me try. Okay, in this, one more thing which is very important is questions which are past, present and future questions. This is again a very important data that we need to record when we do the counseling for the problem solving methods. So when it is related to the past present questions, what are the things that we need to have in our mind and in the client's mind? Is that what experiences have you had here that led you to where you are today in life? So what are the different, if it is not so, in what situation do you think that you will be there? And how the relationship with other people you had in the past and how did it contribute to the present situation? So that is one thing. Then what are the lessons that you have learned from the past experiences and how to move about it? And so do you agree with these that the solution will be a solution to the past experiences that you have learned? And what are the challenges that you will face in this present situation? Are you adapted? Are you equipped well for the present situation?
Sorry to interrupt. I think your slide is not sharing. Yeah, I know that you try to open the slide, but the slide is not sharing. It's not showing to us.
Let me try. One more time. Thank you. Thanks for that mention. Hope, is it visible now?
Nope. You're only showing us your directory. You just show us the directory. You have double-clicked your past, present, and future questions. But the PowerPoint slide is not shared.
All right. There is some problem in sharing, I think. Let me just check.
That happened to the previous topics. You also tried to open.
In the previous. Okay.
Yeah, same.
Let me try for one more time. Hope it will help us now. Not this one. This is the one. No. Hope, is it visible now? It should be visible, I think.
Yes, excellent. Yeah. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. So, in this present situation, so this, use these questions as a rough guide to keep the flow of the conversation during the exercise. So, you can change the question depending upon the flow of the conversation and the responses your client gives. So what experiences have you had that has led you to the present situation and how your life has been so far and how was your relationship with the people in your past and how they were able to contribute, were they helpful, everything has to be recorded such that we understand this person much better. So what lessons have you learned from the past experiences and what challenges have you faced in the past experiences and how did you overcome it and what have you learned about yourself? About yourself, how you have evolved during this challenging situation, sir. And what are the strengths that you developed along the way in this present situation as a learning experience? And how would you compare your life with the past and the present today? What's it likely today? And what is your relationship with other people when compared to the past? And what are you passionate about and how to move about it? What are you looking forward to do in the future? And how the present situation, the present evolution is going to help yourself to move into the future. So this is again very important, past, present and future questions that they need to put it down and they will be able to share it so that to get a better understanding of exactly what are we talking, who are we talking about and what are they up to. And so is there a question shown here or the PowerPoint now? The PowerPoint is back. Are we back to the PowerPoint?
Yes.
Okay. So when we have analyzed this person very clearly, about the problem very clearly, now the
It's not a PowerPoint. Now you're
It's a slideshow.
Yep. Back to the PowerPoint.
Yeah. Can we move ahead?
Yes, please. Thank you.
Thank you. So in that case, what is the main thing that our focus as a coach, as a trainer, what should be focusing on? You can contribute, but since my time is very short, I'm just moving forward. The challenges that she has listed in that quote, in the writing, exactly to the answer to the questioner, what are the challenges, what are the shortcomings that she has written, should be our focus point, our focal point, such that we will be able to guide her to the next steps, or at least we know exactly how to counsel her to come out of those challenges, to challenge those challenges and to equip her to come out of the situation. So how will we achieve our goals? As we are going to plan for setting up goals tomorrow, the SMART goals, we will be talking about this planning and achieve these goals tomorrow. But still, For all these things, the counseling session as a trainer, I have explained to you the process of counseling, how to understand your client, the first interview session with the client, how to note down the points, how to understand your client, how to understand the problem, and how to analyze the problem situation such that how to record it, how to because data is very, very important. Then we talk about different things, but exactly what is required is that how to record it. So records and the evidences are very, very important. Who are the people who are working? So this is actually the process of problem solving. So for all these things, what is required is a proper mindset is required for people to evolve and change. End of the day, what happens in the problem solving situation is that a change happens. Sometimes the change is big, sometimes the change is very small. So even then, what is required is the mindset of the people changes such that their approach to the present situation changes such that they are able to move further from where they are stuck, and they are able to solve their problem on their own. Remember, we are only guide, we are only a facilitator for an existing problem for our friend, but we are not going to give them the solution. So in that, we are going to empower them to unleash their competence and to lead them to a culture of the new with the innovator's mindset that is empowering the learning to unleash the talent and lead to the creativity of the new. So moving ahead, as we have seen, this is a typical situation of exactly how they have made use of the situation of the bottle as a light, the bottle filled with water as a lighter. What is very key thing, very important in this picture is not, of course, the kids, of course, the light, and of course, the situation of innovation they've just come up with, the art of innovation that they have come up with, the light. What is very key thing is the one which is there, something new, something which is useful. So our solution to that problem, our guidance to the solution should be useful for the client such that they are able to resolve the problem. So that is what is the thing. There's one other example with the innovative thinking, with the innovator's mindset. What has come up is this lady was supposed to carry water from her friend. So what should she do? She didn't carry the pot. There's of course a pot that she's, there's a can with a lid. So she had made a wheel such that she's able to fill the water and she's moving ahead. So we have to come up with a situation such a way using our creativity to move ahead such that end of the day what is required is that is useful for the person. How far is it useful to that person is what is the outcome exactly. Anything which has been, it has an input should have an output, and the output should be useful to the people who are there. Exactly. I'm trying to give you the situation from the business scenario as well. Moving ahead, most startups fail because of lack of customers from the failure of the core product. It is not that. It is exactly the problem solving versus problem finding. Unless and otherwise you find the problem very clearly, will not be able to do that. So when you have a problem and when you know a solution, when you have a problem, this is how the innovative mindset thinks. When you have a problem, you have a solution for it, then why worry? Just do the solution. And when you have a problem, when you don't have a solution, you're still working on it to find a solution, then why worry? In either cases, it's just absurdity to be worrying on it. And instead of worry, just do something. Problem, think about a creative solution that you can arrive at the solution such that you are able to overcome the challenge and move ahead. So theoretically, when you talk about problem solving, these are the different cycles. I am sure many of you might be knowing it. That is PCDA circle. What is that? Plan, do, check, and act. So that's PCDA circle. The second one is, those who have done Six Sigma, they will know DMAIC. That is, define the problem, measure the problem, analyze the problem, improve yourself, you work on it, and you improve, and then you take control of the situation. So that's how we resolve the problem. The third is that change that it's structural situation. That is, focus on the problem, approach, change your approach, use different approaches such that you are able to converge, test, implement it, understand it, apply it, and you are able to come out of it. The third is that AD methodology. That is, you will find you will be able to form a team. If it is in a corporate scenario, that's what I'm talking about. You will be able to form a team, describe the problem, analyze the problem. You have an internal communication very clearly so that you know your process of very clearly approaching the problem. Analytical, theoretical audit reports are being analyzed very clearly, and then you work on it. You work on it in a sense, team-wise you work on it. Finally, when you work in the management, that is micromanagement, macro management levels, that you work on it. And moving ahead, how to thinking about the opportunities, thinking about the threats, how to overcome the threats, everything. Finally, you will be able to arrive at the situation. So, thanks. I'm sorry, I'm going a little fast on this because this is a very detailed thing that we need to do one by one. Maybe in due course of time, in the next sessions, we can go about it in detail. So, for all these things, what is required is your thinking. As I told you, thinking is the best thing. Your problem is definitely not at all a problem. Problem is actually a small dot which is there. But when you look at it, the way you look at it, as everybody knows an example, on a white sheet of paper, there is a small dot. How do you look into it? The big paper is to your sight, or the small dot which is there to your sight is what is the thing. When you look at the problem, you have to look at it with the divergency thinking and also with the convergent thinking. End of the day, thinking out of the box, you need to arrive at the later thinking. So when you look at the divergent thinking, what you will be doing? You will be having imagination. It will be an idea, creative thinking. This will be that, this will be that. Why not I do this? Why not I do this? When this creative thinking happens, that is followed by the convergent thinking that has a logical, statistical, analytical facts which are with evidences, such that you come out of the letter thinking or thinking out of box solution to it. So this is how we normally resolve problems. For all these things, what is very important, what quality is required. Now, we have talked about the analytical processes which are involved in it. Now, talking about the skill, what is required is that metacognition is the best skill that one should have when you think about a problem. What is metacognition? Metacompetence definitely helps the processes to become better thinkers. Now, what is metacognition? It is from the cognition, the process of knowing, from to learn and to know. That is, from the one that you know already, you analyze it and you go explore it, you go deep into it, put on your thinking cap to know more about it. That is what is metacognition, for example. So, thinking about one's thinking is that metacognition refers to the awareness of one's own knowledge. That is what is important. What do I know? That is, if you're a teacher, you will be able to relate it. That is KWL chart. What do I know? What I'm learning now? What I'm going to learn for the future? So, knowing yourself very clearly, you be aware of yourself and what is one does not know exactly. And also, what you know, what you does not know. That also very important. And also ability to understand and control and manipulate the cognitive process of one's thinking, such that you are able to think about yourself, your capacities, your competencies. You are able to think about the problem. Okay, the problem magnanimity, everything graphically you will be able to, categorically you will be able to analyze, plan a strategy for approaching such a task, and then you will follow the next steps to evolve, solve your problem, reflect on it, evaluate results, and modify the approaches which are required. So in this, what happens in the process is your mindset becomes a growth mindset from the fixed mindset. So the changes versus fixed versus the growth mindset happens. It increases motivation and effort. It includes the ownership and it also has positive attitudes and it increases the performance. So to create this developmental process of metacognition, what is required from us is the ability to think. Is visible such that you are able to analyze the process and you are able to give up solutions, come up with the solutions. So you are able to, you develop an ability to regulate your thought process, thinking about everything, understanding of exactly what we know and how we think, including the ability to regulate our thinking and we work on a task, and it acts as an internal guide that notices the questions of self in different situations. And the attention and the comprehension, everything put together, it helps us, it develops, it improves our thinking capacities. And finally, what we evolve, we become empathetic, we become problem finders, we become risk takers, we become network, we become observant, we become creators, we become resilient, we become reflective of our own performances, such that with the innovator's mindset, we will be able to analyze the problem, and that brings up so many evolution in us, such that we are able to resolve the problem with exactly what you know. So these are the different 8 metacognitive skills that with the innovative mindset we will be able to arrive at. So you know exactly what you are good at, monitor your performance, you seek out to others' feedback, because you have become open, you maintain a diary to keep on the data and the evidences, you ask yourself good questions such that you are able to, if not this, if this, if not this, so you will be able to, you become more analytical and you react in a better feedback way, and you are open for feedback, and so that you will be able to prepare you, even your failures you will be able to treat as a learning experience. You will be able to prepare yourself properly, set your goals, and you will be able to resolve the problem with a very 360 degree quiet analysis. So in that case, what will be your next step? You will create an environmental plan, building relations, connections, confidence, protected by care, love, trust, and trust of thankfulness, such that we are able to take hold of the situation that we are in. And thus, I think we have taken all the 8 qualities that we, or the skills that we will imbibe in this process of problem solving. So what happens here in the state of art of problem solving is the change. And the change begins one day with you. From the static mindset to the growth mindset, that is the fixed mindset to the growth mindset, such that you are able to dwell into your own fixed mindset to understand the shortcomings, reflect self by accepting criticism, by graceful receptiveness, self-motivate intrinsically and eccentrically to come out of your vicious circle, focus, plan and work towards converting all these possible threats into opportunities, establish the change really matters by convincing your success. So the change begins within you. So what do you do in this process to develop the problem solver's mindset? You expand your horizon, embrace the trinity of trait, engage in constant learning, esteem your growth, endow your plan, envisage every single moment as learning, eulogize life with gratitude, and empower self. So this is what the problem solver's mindset is all about, and that's how they evolve into. With all the 8 principles of problem solving, you empower yourself by spearheading problem solving mindset within self. So how do we go about it? So every time when we think or act, our neuron sends signals, and these signals are responsible for every single step that you take, and every heartbeat and every thought and every action and every emotion, whether it is positive or negative, has influence to it, and it has a recurrence of this pathway into the brain, arbitrates the process to achieve the best. Configure your internal engineering network by developing positive signals, connections and strengthening bias. So seed in positivity so that you will be able to reap positive bias. That means when you are with a problem, you don't need to get scared. The neurons that fire together, wire together. That means you have your positive signals, positive vibes within you, so that you will be able to handle the situation with much more grace, and you will be able to handle it. So embrace the trinity of trait cluster by igniting your curiosity. Second is that when you are bold enough to handle a situation, you always spark your curiosity. Curiosity combines intelligence, persistence, hunger for novelty, all wrapped in one. Curious people keep on moving forward, opening new doors to welcome in you. Curious thinker, best position to thrive today, in the future, will be proactive in the highly competitive world. Their curiosity will lead them down to new paths to embrace change with various elective perspectives and collaborate with those of specialization. So in this process, what happens when you have your curiosity, when you have the innovative thinking, when you know exactly, when you are able to, when you are willing to learn from exactly known unknown to known, so there is a constant learning that is taking place. So who dares to teach must never stop learning. So lifelong learning creates a positive attitude towards learning and earning. Our capacity to earn and directly related to willingness to learn, and so to deliberate a voluntary act, such that we are not static with the problem, we are not stuck with the problem, we explore, we engage ourselves, we explore ourselves, and we just experience the situations such that we are able to come up with the new solutions. So, with that motivation, so when we go, we set our goals towards the progress, aiming high. So anything is possible with that particular positive mindset. When we analyze a problem, success is all yours. So with that indomitable spirit and grit, so we should move on to that, to the graceful solution of solving the problem. So in this process, what is it? Another thing which is very, very important, sorry, I should have mentioned it before, but still, let me just take it up here. When you arrive at a problem, when you are able to solve a problem, it may be a success, definitely. But it will be a short, sometimes it will be a short-term success, sometimes it may be a long-term success. So always treat success means what's next step. What is the meaning of success is what's next. It's just that. Success is always a very short-lived time. So when you have resolved a problem, immediately focus on exactly what could be next. What is going to come up next? That what is the thing? So when it is a failure, it doesn't matter. It is always a learning. In either ways, if you see, it is only a learning experience such that we are able to move ahead in our life from where we are stuck. So, like if you are going to take life as it is with a sense of gratitude, it is a great thing that we will be able to practice and such that we will be able to conquer love with the way it is, and we will be able to design or culture our own destiny. Moving ahead, do I have time to continue? I just want to know. Ma'am, should I take it up tomorrow or should we continue?
Ma'am, tomorrow's session is a different session, so if you want to add up something in today's this, you can continue.
Okay, thank you. So, in this, now we are moving further. This, we are going to talk about capacity building. So, when you have this kind of situation, problem solving, what is very much required in us is that, as we have seen, so far we have seen how to analyze a problem, how to go about it, and then what all things that we need to think when we need to imbibe in self or look into ourselves.
Sorry to interrupt. Yes. You make it as not, presentation mode.
So far we have seen how we can analyze a problem, how should we look at the problem.
It's not on the presentation mode yet. You are still on your
PPT mode. It is loading. It's loading.
Yeah, I understand there's challenges. I think there are also some feedback from the chat box. You might want to read the chat box. There's some feedback from the learner. So you might also want to and pay attention to the feedback and the request, the needs from the learner. Thank you so much, Dr. Smith.
Thank you.
We really appreciate your expertise, but I think at a certain point of time that when the learner gives feedback,
that's why I asked, should we go ahead or should we? Can I have Aishi?
Yes, I'm here.
Yeah, please go ahead, Aishi.
Yeah, I was
can
just
you on your video camera.
No, I can't on my camera. There's a guest at my home. But I was facing the issue that everything was good, but you were not explaining much. You were just reading the PPTs at the last. Before you were explaining in the writing slides, but later on you were just reading. So it's very difficult to make us understand, because reading we can also do by ourselves.
So what do you want me to do? You want me to give an
example? Little bit explanation that, examples that we can use in our daily life also.
Okay, every day life situation, what do I think? Okay, one example which I would like to really give. Say for example, like this is called as 80-20 chart. People who are in the counseling or as a mentor or a coach, they will know about this 80-20 principle, definitely. Probably, may know your background, Aishi?
Yeah, I'm a trainer, I'm a beginner in this, but I don't know the 80-20 principle.
Okay, fine. So is that how you react to the situation? How you react to the present situation? It was a morning scenario. Since you have asked for it, I would like to know the answer from you only. Okay? So, it is a morning scenario.
Okay.
Yeah, please go. Okay, fine. Can I go ahead?
Yes.
Yeah. It's a morning scenario. Basically, it's a morning breakfast table. So when the parents are having breakfast at the table, it's a morning scenario in the sense you can understand. They have a child who is going to school and the child is supposed to catch the school bus. That's the actual thing. And the breakfast has been laid and the milk is kept on the table. So the child was getting ready to school and she came and she dropped the milk. And so, how do you expect the parents to react to the situation? And you can give me examples of exactly what you think as a parent, what would they have done and how they will handle the situation.
First of all, his child is getting late for the school, then there is a reason because there's a fixed time of the school. Maybe the child woke up late. Maybe he was or she was busy in another activities. That's why he or she got late. So they were not ready. Means they don't know.
I repeat the question to you one more time. Sorry, because it's a morning situation. The morning situation is a breakfast table, and the breakfast is laid on the table. The child spilled the milk on the floor. I mean, the glass has been slipped away from the table, and the milk is split, and the glass is broken. So, how exactly this is the situation? If you're a parent, or if the same situation happens in for you at home, how would you react to it? How would you resolve the problem, or how to move about it? That's what is the thing.
As for me, I will react in a soft manner. I will not shout at the child, and I will not show my frustration. It happens with anyone. According to me, I will react in a very positive and soft spoken.
In this situation,
it can happen with me also.
Okay, yeah, that's good. Okay, fine. What do you think is the actual problem there? In that particular situation, I'm not talking about the background. The background of the problem is totally different. As I told you, when you interact with the client, when you interact with the client as a coach, the background of the problem will be N number of problems might be there. As you were mentioning, as you were elaborating, the child getting up late in the morning, the child maybe taking, was not prepared to go to school, the child may be ill. So these kind of reasons, 1, 2, 3, 4, will come in your analytical evidences. But our problem, actual problem of that morning, what was that?
Actually, the child was getting late, so he was in or she was in a hurry. So maybe due to that, the glasses slipped off from the hand.
I agree. Again, you're going to the factors that is influencing the problem. The actual problem is the milk is split and the glass is broken, and so that the child is not going to have breakfast, the child will not have milk, and the place has to be cleaned. So that is the actual task that has to be done. That is the actual immediate task for the problem, or our focus should be exactly for that problem. So in that case, if you want to guide your client or the person who has come to you for counseling, how would you guide them? Is that okay? Fine. If this is a scenario, what is the next task? So moving forward, your focus should be on the next task, what you're going to have. The next task is catching the bus. So in that case, they cannot think about the previous problem, the child illness, the child got up late, or getting late to school, or doesn't want to go to school. All these factors that influence the problem will not come into the thing. How to catch the bus, the school bus, without getting missed. That is what is the actual task. That is a challenge. So that is the opportunity. So if they are going to analyze, if you are going to guide your person to analyze exactly, focus on the challenges, what is the next challenge that you are going to have, then moving ahead, you will be able to guide them to arrive at the solution. Immediately they will say, okay, we'll come and clean it later, and so that we will just take her, we'll change her dress, we'll change her uniform, we will make her comfortable, we'll give her one more glass of water. All these things will follow through next, in the sense. So our challenge, what is the actual challenge is that? Is that main thing is how to catch the school bus. That's the actual problem. So your focus should be catching the school bus. Very importantly. Right? So as a trainer, your focus should be on solving the challenges, looking at the SWOT analysis, saying that if this is the strength, if this is the weakness, if this is the opportunity, if this is the threat that you are going to, how to overcome this challenge. This is what is the actual instance. So if we are going to go about it on one-to-one basis, I'm sure there are so many people here, they will also have instances and examples to be clarified on this. Definitely we'll have more sessions. Moving ahead, can I go ahead with my presentation or anybody else would like to add on?
I have one question only. It may happen that whenever we are going for an interview, either it's online or offline, either we are prepared or not, but we have knowledge about it. But still, we get a positive response in the interview, but later on we will not get any positive response. They said, no, we will hire another candidate because of any reason. So how we can do that? Sometimes if you get the answer, even if it's happened in 2 to 3 interviews too.
Exactly. When we were talking about the growth mindset and the fixed mindset, what did you understand by the growth mindset? What is the skill that is required in us? Main thing. Moving forward. Exactly. What is required to metacognition? Is a creative.
But these are the questions coming in the mind that why he has not hired me, why everything was good and all. Even they were very much agree on our points, but still they deny due to any reason. These are the questions that continuously comes up in the mind.
Exactly. They will be able to justify themselves, as I have already mentioned about the past, present, future questions. In this situation, it is a typical situation of an interview, failure in the, or not getting successful in the interview of 3-4 interviews, right? If this is a situation, have they put it down in the past experiences? What are the learning experiences from the past experience, from the first interview, second interview, third interview? You have the evidences very clearly, such that do you see him growing or learning from the past experiences? Do you see the client growing or learn from the past experience? Has he evolved himself? Has he learned something? Is he moving forward? Has he brought into the art of metacognition in him? And if at all, moving ahead, the one which I stopped here is very, very important. Being resilient, exactly. How to overcome the actual situation? What is required in us? What is the change required in us? The best thing is, as I told you, as I gave the example of the person, the one who just walked into the first day of office, you can't blame the factors that are influencing the situation or the environment. You have to always look into yourself, how am I going to resolve it? What am I going to do it to make the situation better? So that way you know yourself rather than thinking about other factors. Other factors are just influences that are contributing to the present situation. But the person who is going to actually do is only you. You are the person who is going to handle it.
But you know it really well. Don't know the reason. If you don't know the reason that why we are rejected. Because most of the time you're not getting the reason also.
No. When you go for an interview, always you can ask for a reason. You can write to them. You should know the reason. Thank you so much. Thanks very much for the opportunity. I was looking forward to work with you, definitely. May I know the exact reason, like of exactly when, what is the reason for my setback or the way they want to put it, why I was not selected or what is that you want me to just work on more. They are supposed to reply back to it. Definitely they will do it. So that has to be evidence from the first interview, second interview, third interview rather than going to the fourth one. So if you don't learn from the first 3 examples of instances, how do you expect? In fact, the first interview, when you have failed also, immediately before going to the second interview, this is what everyone is expected to do. So that's how we move on in life, right? So in that case, this has to be evidence before going to the second one. As a coach or a trainer, you are supposed to guide them through exactly. So this was the first interview, what went wrong, even the dress counts, even the body language counts, even the way they would have reacted counts.
But it may also happen that every problem is not within us. Maybe some other certain criteria that we are not matching. I mean, sometimes I feel that them and
interviewers are not serious to hire. And they also
Again, I'm sorry, Ms. Ayushi. I'm again stressing, you're not getting the point actually for the whole session. As I told you, you are always focusing on the other factors. Even the first previous example, you were focusing on the other factors. That is, the child got late, the child was sick, that, yes.
You need, should you not can, focus on that.
Other factors, exactly. That is what is very, very key thing of the problem solving. Because you know yourself very clearly, and you know how you will be able to handle the situation very clearly. You know very, very, very clearly exactly what is required from you and out of you to handle the situation. What I need to do, that only you can handle your situation rather than handling the other situations. I think you got your problem very clearly.
Yes,
you understood your problem. So can we move ahead? Yeah. Vidya ma'am, should I go ahead or what would you suggest? Okay. So this was a video. I thought, okay, fine. Taking into
Vidya, yes, you can proceed further. And okay. I feel whatever questions even Ayushi asked, Ayushi, you understand the in-depth subject of this training session. Herein, we are guiding you how to be a good certified trainer rather than having the interview session, because I feel interview sessions and trainer, these are completely two different perspectives. Am I right, Dr. Srividya?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So, Ms. Ayushi, whatever are your questions, you can jot it down, right? We will try to answer that. You please proceed, Dr. Srividya.
Which yeah, I'm not sure. Agree with your statement, whatever you have said right now.
Okay, fine. See, every statement that we make, that has always, as per the person, as per the trainers, the opinions always vary, whatever statements are made. Even in the training session, whatever is being delivered, we may not agree as a trainee, right?
No. Dr. Srivda, sorry to stop you there. Ayushi's problem, I told her very clearly, she is always focusing on the factors rather than working on herself.
Yeah, so even I think whatever issues, you can put it in the chat box, we'll answer you, Ayushi. Thank you. Please proceed, Dr. Srividya. Sorry to interrupt you.
It's okay. Fine. Thank you, ma'am. So, what is required in that situation, like as Ayushi was mentioning, failing about 3-4 times, what is the thing? Resilience, the art of resilience. It's the capacity to recover quickly from all the difficulties by looking into yourself. That is what is important. So resilience means the act of rebounding, springing back often from immaterial, such that you are able to recoil in the physical sciences and you are able to bounce back by not giving up, such that. So, being oneself, looking into the mirror, when you look into the mirror, you identify your true magnificent self. Rather than looking exactly the other factors that we are thinking about, look into yourself so that you will be able to rediscover your own self moving ahead. Okay, so discover yourself, and being resilient is knowing the one you, who you are and who has the power and the responsibility to pick up and move forward. So believe you can, and you are always there, you are halfway there. So if you look at this tree, the tree is cut, but exactly the tree which has been fallen has given rise to 4 more trees. The tree which has refused to die has grown 4 more trees out of itself. So this is what happens when we really don't quit. So what is required in problem solving? Resilience is the capacity to recover quickly from difficulties by looking into ourselves. So you grow through what you go through. Thanks, Ayushi, your examples, your interview session is going to help me a lot, I think, so when we talk about resilience. So failure is not just one instance or one experience of life. It is just a part of life. So go through what you go through, and life is not about how many times you fall down. It is about how many times you bounce back. That is what is problem solving is all about. So every time when you get up as a new person. So look at the life of an eagle as a best example of becoming resilient. There's a video again. I wanted to show the video. I'm not sure whether the video will play because it is taking quite a long time to load. We'll have a look at it in the next session if we can. So building up resilience, what does it require? How do we build up resilience? If at all for a problem solving, if you think that resilience is a capacity that one should develop, how do we develop resilience? Is that growing up with confidence, developing competencies? Means what is not there, look into yourself, evolve, imbibe those skills which are required. Developing self-control is again very important. That means two instances that we discussed, even the breakfast scene that we discussed, developing self-control to manage the situation, to overcome the situation, instead of reacting to the situation in a negative way, you unlay the situation and respond to it in a positive way such that you are able to move. Coping up with the situation, exactly, and developing a character for yourself, and you become connected. So this is what is a resilience is all about. And moving ahead, how the seven C's of resilience help in self-development to develop the art.
Sorry, are you showing some slide or something like that? I'm just not sure that. We really appreciate your content, but is there some visual things there? Thank you.
Yeah, it was there actually. The video didn't play. Okay, so when it comes to developing competencies, exactly. Competence, exactly, is the ability to handle the situation effectively. Hope you will agree with me. As you know, when we become competent, we develop the skills that allow us to trust our judgment and make us make responsible choices. That is what is very important as a trainer. You need to jot down the points very clearly. You need to make them evident every single meeting with your client such that they are able to make their own judgment of themselves and make responsible choices that are suitable to them. So they learn, unlearn, relearn, and like they captivate the most critical thinking skills that analyze, continually evaluate and challenge the knowledge and to ensure that relevance which is up to date such that they are able to totally evolve to handle the situation. So that is what is the thing of developing competences is all about. Be open to learn, unlearn and relearn such that anything which is required to handle that particular situation, you will be able to equip yourself and you will be able to evolve. So when I'm unlearning, so exactly, ignoring my previous boundaries, the previous misconceptions that I have, only this is possible for me, making myself fit to the social situations, the new adaptation which is required, and also, if at all I need to imbibe a new skill which is required, say you are taking up a new job, you are supposed to drive, so that you are able to pick up driving, exactly, as a skill. You need to transport, you need to go by car, you need to drive to your office. You are learning a new skill such that you are asking for support and you are able to come out of the situation yourself as a person such that we are able to guide our clients in such a way. What is very important is to develop a new skill that is required to develop a new skill or unlearn, relearn the new skill that is required such that you are able to handle the situation in a much more way and also such that it is more useful for us in arriving at a solution for the existing problem that we have. So we move from our comfort zone where we are safe and controlled. We come out of our fear zone where we know how to handle the excuses and we develop self-confidence and we are not affected of others' opinions. And we move across and we go to the learning zone where we are open up to acquire new skills that are required. As I told you, if at all you are taking up a new job, taking driving as a new course that you have to, or otherwise any other communication skill or IT skill that you need to recruit. So acquiring new skills again very important at the learning zone, and such that you are totally you extend your comfort zone and you also deal with challenging the problems that you come across in the learning zone. When it is a learning zone, there will be a lot of failures, as I just told you. So every failure that you learn as a learning experience and you move on. And such that you arrive at the growth zone where you set new goals for yourself, you conquer all your objectives, you live in your dreams and you find a purpose for life. So that's how we do it. So for doing this, we do need the six type of courage, physical courage to going up with resiliency, balance and awareness, social courage to be yourself unapologetically, such that you are open to change, open to any criticism which comes across. You develop moral courage to do the right thing, what is uncomfortable and what is unpopular, and being very frank, as Ayushi was open enough to come up and ask questions that is quite unpopular, that we maybe she is doing the right thing, and it has the emotional courage to the feeling of emotions of positive, negative, and the guilt of attachment. Intellectual courage to learn, unlearn, and relearn with an open and flexible mind, and also the spiritual courage with a heart-centered approach for one's life and dreams and aspirations. So moving further, exactly, growing up with confidence. So you bloom up with your own confidence. Confidence is a solid belief to one's own abilities, and we gain confidence and to handle any kind of situation such that we are able to resolve the problem with much more vigor and also zeal and determination. Again, this is a video. I'm sorry, I will not be able to run the video because of the problem that we have.
We can skip the video. Important is the PowerPoint visual so that we can understand what you're speaking.
Yeah.
And we make reference to the PowerPoint. Yeah. So let's make it easy for everybody. Thank you so much.
Okay. And so if you learn, what is very important is that is a lot of self-control. As I cited about breakfast morning scene, exactly. So how do you react to the situation? How do you respond to the situation? Are you going to react or are you going to respond to the situation? That is what is very important. Developing self-control, you can master anything absolutely, very clearly, understanding the decisions that will affect our lives, learning to take the control of the situation and also ourselves. And we know that with our positivity, with our thinking, with our potential to bounce back, to handle the challenges, we can make a difference. So with the focus of grit and determination, they become resilient to face any kind of challenges that was requested. So finally, when it is problem solving, we are able to cope up with the situation, what is required. We learn to cope up with stress effectively and steer quick fixes.
Sorry, I have to interrupt again. So to solve this problem, since we have been talking about problem solving, to solve this problem of without the visual, can we have a solutions in this Zoom, in the Zoom environment? Actually, you can send the PowerPoint slides to us. So this is one of the solutions for now, this particular situations. So we need to solve the problems now, and let's provide the solutions to the problems now that, and having a lectures, or having a speaking, having a sharing without the visuals can be challenging for some people. So may I request that let's solve the problem of the PPT issues.
Dr. Raymond, sorry to interrupt you. You have sent me the message and I think I replied you. Yes, I will look into it and we will do the needs. Do not worry, sir.
We can send a PowerPoint slides at
yes,
this
sir,
moment
I,
right
replied
now.
To your message, sir.
This
I replied
right
to
now.
Your message. So let her continue, please. Yeah, thank you.
It is very difficult to learn for some.
Srivita, can you send me the presentation or your document? I will present it.
We are here to learn how to become an effective global trainer. So let's be a role model. When we have a problem, let's solve the problem and do not avoid the problems, right? Let's solve the problems now so that we
I don't
can,
understand. If I
thank
share,
you.
No, if I share the PowerPoint, what will be the solution for it?
Okay, under Zoom, at the bottom, under your chat box, so there are three icons. One of the icons is called document. You can attach a PowerPoint by attaching a document.
If at all I'm going to share the PowerPoint, how is it going to help me? That's what is the thing I'm asking.
So at least that there's a visuals to what you are sharing with us. I mean, there's a lot of content, excellence content. Yeah. I really appreciate excellence content. However, learner, they are VAK, visual, auditory, and kinesthetics. I think these are all the basic things we know. And you are only using the mode of auditory. So what about the visuals way and helping
you? You mean the sharing screen is not happening?
It's not happening. I have been giving you feedback. We are not seeing the PowerPoint slides. I have been giving the feedback that we are not seeing the PowerPoint slides. I'm not trying to make life difficult for you, doctors.
Now is it okay?
Yes. Now we see the slides. Thank you so much. I mean, this is one of the basic things as a trainer, always check whether the participants seeing your slides. This is one of the basic things I always ensure. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Okay. Let me go back. You want me to go back to the slides quickly?
Please. Otherwise, we are wasting our time here. We're just listening to you and we are wasting our time just for the sake of going through the motion. I have to be very strict. I mean, we are all here international trainers. We are all here professionals. We do not want to waste each other's time. Let's be effective. Thank you so much.
Okay. I didn't know that the screen has not been shared. I'm sorry about it. I have been
saying it so many times and I put it in the chat box that we are not seeing your PowerPoint slides. Thank you.
Okay. So now is the screen being shared?
Yes. Excellent.
Okay. Fine. Sure. Thank you. So we are talking about resilience. It's the capacity to recover quickly from difficulties by looking into yourself. So it's the act of rebounding as we come back with the elasticity, with the power of coming back to the original shape and not giving up, right? So when we look into ourselves, we have to believe in ourselves such that we are able to rediscover our true magnificent self. So that is what is very important when you become resilient. So that's the capacity that one has to imbibe and develop when it comes to problem solving. So this was the example which I had given. The tree which has been cut down has developed 4 more trees. That means the tree has not given up. And that means it has grown from exactly what it undergrew, what it has undergone. That is grow through to what you undergo through. So you recover from your difficulties quickly by looking into yourself, such that life is not about how many times you fall down, how many times you bounce back and come back. And every time when you come up, you have your new skill, you have your new quality in life, you have your new adaptation, such that you come up as a new person moving forward. So I really want to share the video, but hope it plays. I'm sure it takes time. Let me just share the video only, if at all I can, in the chat box later. Okay. But it's a very beautiful video of eagle, how it comes up, how it handles its life being resilient. So when it comes to resilience, how do we build up this art of resilience, or the resilience of the skill in us to handle any kind of problem, or how to handle a problem solving method? What are the qualities that we need to imbibe in us? Is that building resilience in you is growing up with confidence, developing competencies, developing self-control, as we have seen in different situations, such that we are able to cope up with the situation and we develop a character and we become connected, contributing to the communities. So that's how resilience helps us to overcome the problems. So how the 7 C's of resilience help a person in self-development is that building competencies. When you build in competencies, it's a capacity to handle the situation, as we have seen in the 2 different instances of the corporate scenario or the breakfast situation. We become competent by developing skills that allow us to trust our judgment, and we make responsible choices for ourselves. We look into ourselves, we unlearn, relearn, and recapitalized more with more critical thinking skills and analyze it so continually and evaluate and challenge the knowledge relevant up to date such that we evolve and we are open to learn, unlearn and relearn and we develop the new skill which is required. As I was mentioning, if you are going to pick up a new job, if driving is a skill which is required to reach your office, such that we look into the past experiences and how, what is a new skill that we look into that and we cope up with the present situation, with the present requirement which is expected out of it, the present challenge which has come to us, such that we learn new things and we move forward. So, such that we come out of our comfort zone where we were very safe and in control. We move out of our, such that we come to the fear zone where we know how to handle our excuses and we build up self-confidence and we don't get affected by others' criticism and we move to the learning zone such that we are able to deal with our challenges and problems, we acquire new skills and we extend our comfort zone to the growth zone such that we start finding purpose for it, we live in our dreams, we set new goals and we conquer all our objectives. So that's what is the art of problem solving is all about. For doing this, we develop the six types of courages which is required, the physical courage, the physical resilience, balance, awareness, social courage to be yourself unapologetically, moral courage, emotional courage, intellectual courage and the spiritual courage is what is required to move ahead. So, when we move ahead with that, we grow up with self-confidence such that we believe in our own abilities, we gain confidence, we demonstrate our abilities, our competence in real life situations and we always make sound choices for ourselves. Sorry about that. So, in this whole situation, what is required is to take self-control, to develop self-control to handle the situation. Such that we understand that our decisions may affect our lives and other lives too. So, we don't jump into the conclusion or come into the judgment of what is required. We control ourselves and we know that we can make a difference. We explore the potential of working together positively and bounce back to resolve the challenges. So, with the focus, grit and determination, we become resilient to face any kind of challenges that is required in our problem-solving approach. So moving ahead, we cope up with the situation, we cope up with stress, whichever situation it is, whether it is stress or any other kind of situation, with our positive adaptive coping mechanism that we have regained from the previous learning experiences and we prepare ourselves to overcome our life challenges effectively and categorically. So when we do that, we get connected, we become open-minded to accept what comes out of the situation. We become one of the key requisites that of unconditional love and acceptance, accepting all kinds of differences that we come across to, and we empathize each and every situation with more kind of inclusiveness, tolerance and a positive approach, helping us to be seen, heard, understood and help them accepted such that we value all connections from the school, local community and to the wider world, such that we are able to develop a character for ourselves because the change has come in ourselves. Because we
You are still stuck at slide 63 and you are not on the presentation mode. So you just caught up with the slide 63 and now you're speaking 64, but it's not in the presentation mode. So we can only see a very tiny slides on the left side of your PowerPoint. So you just press presentation mode. Then we can see all now will become in sync. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
We are not seeing the slide yet. There's no slides. Now the slides is gone. My apology if you deem that I'm too disruptive, but I feel that this is the minimum standards. Yeah. The minimum standard as a trainer, that your PowerPoint slides must always in line with what you're speaking. My apologies to the rest of the learner, because I feel that it is also that as an international trainer, we also want to ensure. We can see your PowerPoint slide, but you are not in a presentation mode. That's why it's only in a very tiny slides. Yes, press from current. Yes, just press there.
Okay.
Nope.
Is it visible now?
No, it's still in the tiny mode. Yeah. Is everybody seeing the full PowerPoint slide, or you just only me? Is everybody having the same problem, or just only me?
Because when I present,
we're seeing what you're seeing, Dr. Raymond. The same what you're seeing.
Thank you so much. I hope that you all appreciate that I voice it out.
Yes, we appreciate the value of knowing that we as global traders should be also vigilant in what we show and what we say.
Yeah, we need to be role models. We need to role models, become an international trainer as well.
Is it seen now?
The rest?
We can only see the PowerPoint, but not as presented. We just only see the smaller part, not yet presented.
I don't know what's the problem. You're not able to see it?
It's okay, now I can just zoom it in. And everything will be fine. We are enjoying it. Thank you.
Hello. Should we move ahead, or what should we do?
No. You can move ahead. You can complete whatever you want to.
No, let him respond. Hello. I'm not able to see exactly what is being presented, no? So I'm not able to see that. Hello?
Yes, you're presenting it correctly right now. So we're on the slide where be proud of every star on your heart.
Be proud of the star. Okay, thank you so much. Whoever it is, I really appreciate it. Your gracious support there. Okay.
Thank you.
So, thank you so much. Okay. Be proud of your every star on your heart, and each one holds it every time, worth of every lesson. So, don't be ever ashamed of the star that life has left with you. Move ahead such that what you have learned from your star is only a tattoo that or a triumph to be proud of. And don't allow your scars or your learning experience or your failures to affect you. Move ahead. That you evolve and you change, like as the butterfly moves out, and the transformation is going to be very easy as the butterfly comes out from the pupa. So, never feel down. Never you don't let others to influence your thoughts and your emotions to come up, such that don't feel rejected. Don't ever feel that you have failed, you're abandoned, you're broken, or if you fail. Move ahead with self-respect, dignity, and pride. As such, you smile, laugh, and live, and never be afraid of falling apart, and trust blindly such that you are humble, honest, beautiful, and you are you as such, because you are real. And you can be successful in life, in your goal, you understand your obstacles. You can create positive mental picture, clear your mind of those self-respect, self-doubt, and embrace the challenge, pray on the cross, and show the world that you can do it. And because the best way to destiny is to create it, and you strive and you drive it. So let's go for it with our problem-solving skills that we have learned here today, because in a world of price tags, you are so priceless. Thank you so much. With that, we have come to the end of this session, and all your questions, kindly share in the chat box. We would like to answer the questions. And it's already 8 o'clock. I leave it to Dr. Smidja to take the lead. And Dr. Charles, if you have got to add on, please add on. All the other participants, if you have got to say something, please go ahead. We can start with Leoncio Calderon. Thank you, sir. Thanks for having you here.
Please. Yeah, thank you. In spite of the difficulties, we'll try to, the talk on resilience will always come back to how can we solve the problems being presented. At least we covered some of it, and a good example is what we're having right now, problem with technicalities. But as you said, Dr. Srivijaya, that we have to move forward. So as global trainers, then we have to actually adjust to the changes happening right now. So we understand your situation as much as you also have to understand where we're at, especially with the difficulties we're experiencing. So that's why when you talk about growth mindset and fixed mindset, then we're supposed to actually involve our growth mindset and understand what where we're at right now. So it's a good point. We're experiencing this. We're also growing with you, despite the difficulties we're having right now. Thank you for
that. As I mentioned, thank you so much. That was a very valid point. I would like to add on to you, definitely. As I was mentioning in Arushi's support, the answer that we were giving for Arushi, instead of looking into the factors that are influencing the problem, we need to look into ourselves and resolve the problem. That's what is the main art of problem solving is all about. And I hope everybody will be able to imbibe that particular skill in us, and moving forward, they will be able to do the needful. Ms. Stella Fernandez, would you like to add on more?
I would say that in the beginning of the session, I was following you through. I could understand what you are trying to get us to, how to overcome problems. But when it came to the technical issues, then a lot of confusion. But besides that, what I'd like to say is, a lot of things have been mentioned, but not explained clearly to us. Things like, what is divergent thinking? What is convergent thinking? What is growth mindset? What is metacognitive skills? What is neuroplasticity, neurons? And you see, a lot of technical terms were mentioned, but they were not elaborated enough for all of us to go through the flow of the whole session. So in this way, there's a lot of confusion. Thank you.
Thanks for that mention. As you rightly said, Madam Stella, this is a total science. Metacognition with the neuroplasticity is a science. And as a coach, you know how much time I have studied in this. It's a thesis which we have done in the psychological study. Yes. Exactly. Two, 3 years of study. Yes. In this 40 minutes, if you want me to cover,
yeah,
to mention the aim and to mention definition itself, a big task. You know, hope you will agree with me.
So that's why you need to give us, before your presentation, all the PowerPoint slides. If you give it to us, then as the flow goes on, we can ask you to explain a few things here and there. But with too many problems, this flow of thought and learning how to be a trainer became a problem.
And for metacognition, out of my experience, you should have a session for at least 3-4 hours together to understand what is metacognition, how does it work with the neurons and neuroplasticity and the domains of brain. So basically, I do agree with you. Just to have to relate it, at least I'm happy that you are able to give the terms to me. I feel that this 40 minute session. Thanks for that mention, because at least you have picked up those terms that you are able to reduce it back to me, saying that this is what is mentioned. I think that is more successful enough. Thank you.
I'm going to read up all these things.
Thank you so much. Yes, Dr. Charles.
Srividya, I think he is traveling, Professor okay. Charles. So,
anybody else would like to contribute? Admalit, Alicia.
Hello, Shivra.
Hey,
I do believe that I agree a little bit with Stella Fernandez. Being able to be part of everything that has to do with communication, some of those things that you look into.
I'm sorry, I'm not able to hear. It's too much of echo from your side. I'm sorry.
I am so sorry. Let me put it on the chat. I think that'll be better.
Thank you, Ria. So, Mr. Yakpik, Raymond.
Yes, Raymond.
Is it okay if I'm going to call you Raymond? Yes.
Yeah, just call me Raymond. Yeah, just 2 points. I think in all these kind of professional topics, my first point is that as a trainer, and you just like we say that we have to do our analysis, we have to do our problem solving. So the scoping, my point is that the first thing is about the scoping for the content. So there are always that topics that may need more than 3 sessions, 4 sessions to explain. I think it's fine. So we need to scope within the time that given to us, given to the speaker, given to the trainer. So that's my first point. Second point, I want to also say thank you for your experience, the knowledge, insight that is excellent. Yeah, so I just want to say thank you so much for all the experience and the knowledge you shared with us. And the last point is that really that the perseverance in solving the problem of having a PowerPoint slides. So that is really a show of the perseverance, how to
thank
solve
you,
it.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. And coming to sharing the PowerPoint, it comes to the copyrights. Well, if IUU has the authority to take the copyrights, and they will be able to share the presentation definitely with you. So from my side, I'm always willing to give the support, whatever required, and then we'll move ahead. As it was mentioned during the course, exactly we are going to talk about goal setting. So that's what is the thing. We'll talking about setting up goals and moving ahead when it comes to problem solving. How does the goal setting process help to solve our problems?
I'd like to share something about copyright. Yeah. I teach students in the polytechnic, and we are trainers, and we go there with all our resource materials, but it is given to them and they have access to all our materials. So today's world, we cannot think about copywriting, because you can easily access all this information in the internet. So if you just look at the issue of copyright, then the presentation will not be effective. You see? So the learner needs visual and also verbal. So if only we are listening to you reading away.
I agree. You're talking about the multiple intelligence skills, our theory of multiple intelligences.
Yeah.
I do agree with you. And we'll look into it definitely from the management side. And IUU will definitely get back to you on a positive note on this.
But your content is very good. Very good content. I can see that there's a lot of things that as a trainer in problem solving, we need to pay attention to. The only thing is it's too fast and too much and within a very short time. So the ability to grab the concepts are not enough. That's all. But you did a very good job. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Manishal. Thank you so much.
Thank you. I think, Srivaddi, it's time. I think all the trainers have given their insights. We will look into the whatever suggestions you have given, that the PPT should be shared. But let me again tell you, this is a very basic course of the 3 to 4 days. This is not a very intensive training. Herein we are just showing you how the trainer to be. This is not a very in-depth training. This is per day 90-minute session only for 3 to 4 days, right? So I think Dr. Srividya, as usual, you have done the excellent and great job.
Thank you.
right? And I feel these days only we are habitual of the PowerPoint presentations. When we were in the school, our teachers used to only speak. We never used to have the visual content, right? So even being a trainer, we should be ready to make the others understand ki if there is no visualization, still we need to understand the things. And we will provide you the recording also, whatever is there, whatever support for this short course, we will certainly provide it to you. Anyways, thank you our Vice Chancellor, Dr. Professor Charles, for being over here. Thank you the entire team. Thank you once again, Dr. Srividya. See you tomorrow with the same zest and enthusiasm. Awaiting to hear your expertise. Thank you all. Have a great day.
Thank you so much. Thank you all. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.